Have you ever wondered whether results of a scientific or technical research may not be applicable equitably to women and men? Gender-blind and gender-biased research methods produce poor science and missed opportunities, often based in gender stereotypes and men as the default generic model for all. While there could be the need for single-sex research, where the results are meant to be applicable to only that sex, often when the research outcomes have implications for human beings, either directly as subjects or indirectly as final users, the study must consider both men's and women's needs and interests. For instance, the effects of passive smoking on children were found to affect girls more than boys. Gender analysis showed that due to cultural gender norms, girls were more likely to play indoors and were therefore more exposed, whereas boys were more likely to be allowed or encouraged to play outside. Another study on men and women patterns in the EU financial sector in 2012 found that women entrepreneurs tend to operate in smaller businesses, usually solo, concentrate on sectors that are considered by financiers to be less profitable, and start off with less capital, borrow less, and use family rather than debt or equity finance compared to men. What happens when a donation request comes from a robot presenting a female or male appearance? In a study run at the Museum of Science in Boston, men were more likely to donate money to the female robot. Participants in general tended to rate the robot of the opposite sex as more credible, trustworthy, and engaging. More women than men died from Ebola virus disease in the three African epicenter countries. Factors were not solely biological, but rather gender-based, given typical women's roles as frontline caregivers and care workers, nurses, mothers, and economic agents in the informal sector. Eating disorders have been characterized as women's problems. Recent studies show an increase in numbers for men. It is uncertain whether this is due to increase in eating disorders incidences or in awareness by men. Many assessment tests were gender-biased, created for females and underscoring males. A study on second-generation metal-on-metal hip prosthesis implants shows failure in women more than men due to hormonal differences. Many examples show the critical need for integrating gender analysis into research. This means taking into account biological characteristics of both females and males, sex, and the evolving sociocultural features of women and men, gender, including considering intersections between sex, gender, and other social categories, age, ethnicity, migration, and so on. In some projects, mainly a sex analysis is relevant. For instance, preclinical studies on cells, tissues, and animals. In others, only a gender analysis is necessary, mainly in studies where biological differences are not relevant. And in other studies, both sex and gender interact and are relevant. IGAR aims to ensure rigorous, evidence-based and ethical research applicable to the needs of everybody and must be considered in all phases of the research cycle, from research question to results dissemination. IGAR outputs can provide useful information and insights to different sectors by showing impacts that can transform society into a more egalitarian one. Efforts are being made to promote IGAR. The GenderNet project funded by the European Commission has developed the present tool to advance IGAR. Many institutions worldwide highlight IGAR as a key driver for excellence in research and the need to promote and monitor IGAR uptake and progress in research institutions. For more information about what you can do for IGAR, you're invited to further explore this GenderNet IGAR tool.